Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. 早上好，下午好，晚上好，大家好，大家好。So for this period, I'm going to show you the character. The first two are actually equal at ancient time. Later on, it evolved to describe different things. 之 or pronounce as 之 Follow me. 之 之 One piece. But what kind of one piece? A vertical shape, thinning, skinning thing, like one piece of pen. 一支笔一支 pen. Or 一支 pencil. One, two pieces of pencil. 两支铅笔 pencil. Vertical. 之 Use this character to describe one piece of something. If something is relatively bigger, a big volume, big mass, we learned before it's called a 个 Remember? 一个人，我是一个中国人，我是一个美国人，我是一个越南人，我是一个英国人，我是一个以色列人 right? 一个人 you cannot say 一只人 right? Because you have a big volume. 一只一支笔 or 一支钢子 small thing, usually it's small and thin, or originally it's coming from a branch of a tree. We're going to talk about that. 枝 then we add the 部首 of a tree or wood, a tree, describe something made of wood. 一支 this originally are two equal character. 花 means flower.Flower. But when this is original one form, then transform to be like this, the original flower become like the glowing thing, the light of something beautiful. You will see somebody in a very good shape, because all you have such light around your face.Around your body. That's the meaning of a hua, the second tone, hua. Original meaning is a hua, flower, hua. And grass, 草, pronounce it with me, 草, 草. Hey, hua, 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 草. The 部首 of 草 is the upper part. Could be separate. Nowadays, we write it like this. They are equal. They are equal.Okay, 草 that's the 部首. An optional character is 竹 bamboo. So this 草 originally written like this. 竹 originally written like this. I'll show you the picture, then you remember. See, you just give your heads up. And we're going to learn this character, nothing less. Nothingness. Nothing. Okay.Let's move on. So we're going to learn the last sentence of this poem. 八九十枝花 8, 9, 10 branches. So remember branches, B-R-A-N-C-H, branches of flowers. 八九十枝花. Let's watch this short video.Pay attention to the tone in the line of the poem. 一去
二三里，宋少雍。
谁？
一去二三里，
一去二三里，谁？
烟村四五家。
烟村四五家，
亭台六七座，
亭台六七座，
八九十枝花，
八九十枝花。See, the pay attention to tone in the sentence. And there has a rhythm too. Some character longer, pronounce longer, some shorter.So the reason, there's a tone up and down.
一去二三里,
it's very musical.
烟村四五家, 亭台六七座，八九十枝花。
It's like, more like singing. So the ancient time, ancient Chinese language, especially in the poems, ancient classical Chinese music is based on the language. Yeah. We'll get more to that. All right. Okay, now let's spend 1 minute to review the character we learned before. 八九十, we learned it before 8, 9, 10, right? 八九十, 八 originally means separate. Anything will grow, we're separate. Like a family, you have mama, dad, have one kid, and two kids, three kids. When they grow up, they're separate. The family is separate. Every single kids have their own family, and the grandchildren born and a different family. So separate is the first criteria to grow. So that's how number 8, original meaning is separate. You know, it won't go this way, it won't go that way, separate. But also, it grow. So that's how Chinese people like number 8, because it grow. It separate and grow. 1 become 2, 2 become 4, 4 become 8, 8 become 16, 16 become 32. 1变成 2, 2变成 4, 4变成 8, 8变成 16, 16变成 32. 变成 transform. Changed to 变成. Number 9, original meaning is a dragon, see? A dragon. Dragon. Dragon has a characteristic, 有一个特点。有一个特点 characteristic, it's always changing. Remember, one dragon mom has nine, ten, or whatever offsprings. They all look different. So that's a character, because one of very significant characteristic of a dragon, changing. So number 9 is the biggest number, because when there, it's going to change. Change to where? Go back to 1. Or 2, or 3, or 4, or 5, or 6, or 7, or 8. Alright. Number 10. Is a verb. Originally is pronounced as Guan, vertical Dao. That's 10. Because this is E, this is R, this is San, this is Si. Then this one transformed to be Si, like this, right? Remember? And this is a Wu, transformed to be like this. Or like this, or like me, I like this. See, that's how the number 5 written like this, including from top to bottom, every level. That's number 10. So, because every level you have horizontal, you have 水平的 Dao. This is Dao, this is Dao too, right? Remember? Okay? So, now, you eventually just this cross, describe. 10. Everything together, 10. Everything on this level, everything on this level. So, simplify as 10. Alright, so this just to help you to understand, to remember it. Now, back to the character we are going to learn today. 知. Follow me. 知. First tone. Number 1, first tone. 知. 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 So, the lower part, 下面这一步,下半步, lower part, 下半步, originally is a hand. Then upper part, it's like this. See here? Usually it's like a branch, describe a grass. Upper part is X, it's a grass. You can write like this, or you can write like this. Single form, like grass. The leaves of a grass, symbolizing. So, like here. Thinner, skinny, long kind of shape of thing called 一支, like pen, 一支笔, right? 一支笔，两支笔，三支笔。So you want to play with it, with number, right? Okay. Singing, like, go directing, like, 一支手机。But we're talking about this thing before, right? This is 个。个 is a big mass. M-A-S is a big one, square one, or big volume. 一个手机。So you can say 一支手机。Also, you can say 一个手机。You can say 一个人。You cannot say 一支人 because I have a big body. Okay. Compare with 一支铅笔、一支 pen, one piece of pen or pencil. Okay. This is the hard part of all for non-native Chinese speakers. Because in English, you say one pen, one mark, one person, or a pen, a mark, a person. You can use a or one to describe everything. But in Chinese,you have to use different character to describe different thing. Okay, 一只 skinny thingy, long shape thing, small thing, small 只一只 You cannot say 一只树 No, you can say one branch of the tree. 一只一只树枝一个树枝 Okay, 树 you want to use a different character to describe 一棵树 Later on, okay.I don't want to confuse you guys and make you feel like, it's too hard. No, it's not too hard, but you just get used to it. 一只 one piece, but long shape. Small thing, small object. 比较小的东西来描述 to describe, 描述。一只 later on, when we describe something made from wood, or especially describe a branch of a tree, you use this枝 see, add, 部首 the tree, the 部首 of a tree, or wood. So, 一枝花 one piece of flower. So flower is coming from a tree or from a grass, right? 一枝 one branch, B-R-A-N-C-H, okay. So, originally, in the very ancient time, these two characters are equal.But later on, they differentiate. This used to describe anything related to wood, a branch. This description, to describe anything. Small object, but a long shape, you know, small thing, one piece. But you can do, if you two together, it's two pieces, 两只三只五支一百支 a box of pencil, we have 100 piece of pencil, 一百支铅笔 100 pieces, 一百支 So you don't need to add S, like English behind it, alright? That's 支 alright? Grass, 草 originally written like this, see? Now, but I use the 草 as a lot of grass together. It's not on a single piece, no. It's not like tree. You could, in a big space, you can only see one piece of tree, but grass usually have bunches of it. So that's how you describe grass. Okay? You see here? That's the grass. Pronounce as 草, follow me. 草, third tone. 草草草草 good 草 and then evolved the written like this in written part written form could be like this could be like this or the same simplify form using this form traditional usually like use this form so you know how it developed right from here to hereOkay, 草 Now, then originally 草 grass written like this. Then, it become a 部首 to describe anything, any character related to a certain kind of 草 or something related to the grass. So, then, we use this character to dedicate describe grass. When this become a radical, become a 不舍, to describe the whole thing. The same pronunciation, 草, s, 草, s, 草, 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 right? 草, 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 grass. This dissect to be two part. Upper part is the 不舍. Lower part, we learned this character before, how to pronounce this. 早, 早上好. See, 早上好. Okay? It's not a really formal way, but it's easier for you to understand, to remember. This is the sun. This is the grass. In the morning, the sun just rises above the horizontal line. So that describes as 早. That's one way to remember how to understand this 早. To help you to remember. But I have to tell you, that's not the original meaning of this 早. When we get more, I'm going to come back to this chapter, how to describe to you what the real meaning of 早. But just like I just told you, to utilize this analogy, help you to remember, it is not a real meaning. Or we can understand it very shallow way to understand the 早, right? But original meaning of a 早 is not like this. Help you to understand the sun, it's a sun, it's a written form, a contemporary form, and the grass over here. The sun rises above the horizontal ground line. That's to describe in the morning. That's to use to be described in the morning. You can use that to help you to understand and remember how to write it in this way. Alright? But remember, it's not a very traditional meaning, original meaning. I'm going to get back to that later when we come to that time, okay? So this is how, when you push down like this, that's bamboo, see here? See here? Bamboo. Alright? There's a lot of good bamboo, different bamboos in Vietnam, right? You guys use that to make furniture or even to build a house. Wonderful job. It's a very good one, actually. When I was a little boy, I followed my father to use the bamboo to make my own toy. Nowadays, the kids can only play with the plastic Lego. They lose the chance to be really close to the nature, Mother Nature, to make their own toy, to be creative. In a way, close to the nature. Yeah. It's a shame. But if you guys have chance, like somebody like Jack, you guys have chance, play in the environment. Be close to the Mother Nature. That's good for you guys. Alright? Okay. That's 草. 草. Follow me. 草. 草. And 竹. Second tone. 竹. 竹, remember this is a 这是部首这是 this is 这是部首 okay 草的部首 so originally see and even though we're the contemporary form written like this actual original form is not it's different so that's how it help you to remember how to write this is a sound and this is a 草 easier in the morning but actually original form.It's written like this. It's different. So we'll get back to that later. Okay. Another character is Hua. Original form is called Hua, but nowadays it's pronounced as Hua second tone. Hua is the first tone. In ancient time, they are equal. So you see, that's the Hua. Upper part.At lower part, written like this, and develop like this. See? Pronunciation is the same, tone different. Hua or hua. Nowadays, we use this to describe all kinds of flower, like peony, like chrysanthemum. It's hard for me to pronounce this kind of chrysanthemum or peony or sunflower or palm blossom. All kind of flower can use this to describe. When this character, the developed one, later coming out, used to dedicate on describing flowers, this character, original character of a flower, is used to describe the glowing kind of way, describe glowing or light. Hua, guanghua. Usually we use these two characters together. Guanghua. You guys remember this character? Light, right? So, remember? Light, sarang. That's called the original meaning of light. Guang. The light on the top of head. Underneath the human. Guanghua. Okay. We use guanghua. The flaming, the glowing thing is described by this character now. Hua. Alright. Guanghua. Alright. Hua, hua. The original hua and become this. When you see a beautiful flower, somehow you can feel the surrounding there is light or glowing. Beautiful. Even a person is very happy, have something good happen to him or her, you can see on the face of this person, it's glowing. That's the hua. Like a flower. Beautiful like a flower, as a hua has a glowing thing around, on the surface, surrounded. Okay, his or her face. Okay? Another character I want to introduce you, it's kind of warming up for next session, next period, next week, is Wu, nothingness. Nothingness. Wu, you have nothing. Original form described from here to here to here to here to here. In Qin Dynasty, it's fixed like this. Basically, this is easier to remember. Basically, describe this of a human here. Getting lost in the big woods, in the forest, because there's too many trees, get lost. Or because it's such a big forest, one piece of, no matter what, a kind of object, count as nothing, count as nothingness. So that's as the original meaning of Wu. It's nothing, it's nothingness, but also, it's also everything. Does it make sense? It's a too many thing. You have too many millions, trillions of things in the same place. One single piece or couple piece of within this such a big mass comes is nothing. So that's original meaning of nothingness. In Taoist school column, everything coming from nothingness. So it means that nothingness actually have everything. Compare this, where you have one piece, two piece, 100 piece of this, that's meaning of trillions of things. That's the meaning of the Wu. It's nothing, it's also everything. Okay, got it? All right, this is this course of pronounced as Wu. Nowadays we use it to describe nothingness too, but actually, this is a very, very ancient form of writing a Wu. It's Dao here, right? And it's another person here. When this person's head breakthrough or understand something higher than this Dao and reaching this higher Dao, become like this. See here. This is a person. This head. Break through this level of Tao, reaching the next level of Tao. That's called Wu. Because compared with this higher level of Tao or realm, underneath everything counts as nothing compared to this realm. Does that make sense? Or you can say, from this level, it has everything. Compared with this level, this counts nothing. Relate to this. You have everything, but every single or individual pieces within this everything is nothing to this everything. Right? Different angle to look at it. So, but in the past 100 years, the scholars they thought this is easier to write because it's simpler, because they pronounce the same, they kind of have a related connotation. So they don't really quite understand the difference between this one and this one. This is more physical. This is more spiritual. All right? But any physical, if you go high enough, it's going to be spiritual. All right? Okay. Does it make sense? Okay. All right. If you have a question, send me your question or type your question and below in the video and below and our comments, and we can discuss. All right. That's the basic, very, very shallow meaning of the Wu. Pronounce with me. Wu, second tone. Wu, 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 Wu. Okay. Now for those you have a good, better foundation, or you learned Chinese before, I introduce another. Remember, I talked about we remember Chinese character by pair. What's called a Yao. Yao. It's a hand on top. Underneath, it's a piece of meat. The hand grab a piece of meat. Meat is some object very vivid. It's kind of real. It's more materialized. It's there. You can grab it. You see it, you can grab it. That's yo, means you have it. It's solid. It's materialized. It's vivid. Compared with this, it's not vivid. You cannot grab it. You get lost in the words. So that's the big meaning of a yo. The pronunciation yo. Third tone. Yo. Wu. So yo. These are optional for you guys. All right. But this one is required in your assignment today. If you can do this in your assignment, you're more than welcome. If you have time, you would like to do it, that's fine. Yao Wu, right? Yo, something visible, tangible, touchable, very materialized. These are kind of more immaterialized, not that materialized. Or you can even do this spiritual thing, mind thing. Break through the level to that level. In terms of, if you look at from high level, lower part is nothing. All right. Okay. All right. That's for today's lesson. Your 作业, 你们的, yours, 你们的, 你, 你好, remember? You, men is a plural. Or you should be written like this. I'm sorry. That. 作业 assignment 作业 读和写的作业 知 this is original form developed to these 知 the same first time 华 original form is 花 Also, if you read in ancient Chinese literature, this also pronounced as hua too. It's two tone. When you describe flower, it's still pronounced as hua. When described as a glowing thing, the light, hua, second tone. Nowadays, we use this to describe the flower. 草, grass. 这是部首。这是字。Right? 选择的 optional, optional. You choose to do it or not do it. That's fine. That's your choice. Optional, 选择。选择的。竹, it's bamboo, 竹。And we talked about this rule. This is required. This is a not required option also. Yo, compare. It's a compare. It's opposite of the rule. You have it. Or not have it. You have it or have nothing. Alright? Alright? That's all for today's, lesson as assignment. Leave your question at the comments below. We can pick up something and discuss in the next period.
谢谢，再见。